Hello, my name is Tamas Bunth, and I would like to present something about databases. But let me introduce myself first. I started to work on LibreOffice around 2 years ago with upgrading the Firebird database management systems driver for LibreOffice. After that, I started to work with Collaborator with a lot of things which are not related to database or databases of LibreOffice base. But after that, I worked, and it was in the winter, I worked on the database migration part, which I want to talk about. First, let me ask a question. Do you know what LibreOffice base is? Have you ever used it? Hands up. Yes, thanks. That's half of the group, which is positive because the other half just maybe just lazy to put the hands up. Thank you very much. Then I would like to talk about what are the main topics of my presentation. I would like to talk about the motivations, then I would go into detail of the development process. Then I would like to suggest further development opportunities. And after that, if I have time, then I will make a demo of the migration thing. So what is it all about? We have this LibreOffice base thing, which is a front end of several database management systems, and we have the opportunity to store our databases embedded into the ODB file, which in which case we can use SQLDB or Firebird as a backend. And there was this idea that not SQLDB should be the default database management systems, but Firebird, which is good for several reasons. For example, we want to get rid of the Java code in the LibreOffice core because it's a big dependency, and we don't want to ship that with LibreOffice, or we don't want the user to configure such things. Another point of view is the developers, because SQLDB is Java-based, and because of that, we need to use Java code from C++. That means through Java native API or something like that. And because of that, it's hard to debug. For example, if you press backtrace from GDB, then you can see the actual SQLDB code just with the mapping to the Java code. Another thing, I think this list is ordered by priority, but it's just my opinion. The last thing might be performance. That means that the C++ native code should be faster than Java code. And I found a question which is interesting in some forum, that why don't we use SQL? And the answer would be for that, in my opinion, that SQLite is not as feature-rich as Firebird, and migrating from SQLDB to SQLite would mean that we lose some features. Okay, so now we come to the tender. TDF has published a tender about this migration thing. When we want to migrate to Firebird, then we have to make the people able to things like in a form of SQL, that means like create table, my table, and so on. And some other informations, for example, it shows us where should we look in the data file, the data. That means, for example, if I have a table called my title, then I got a point from the script file that the data from the my table is located in the at this position in the data file. Okay. I don't know if you can see that, but it's not that important. That's the script file. It's a bit contains SQL, and I wanted to highlight one row, which you see the half of it probably because of this coding. So this is the position in the binary file where we can find the data of table 2. And so we have to interpret all this shape of definition before we migrate the data, and we have to run it on the other database. Okay, and the other part of the work was to interpret the binary file. This is a figure of ABL3, that's a balanced binary tree which contains data. And I got to know that HistoryDB stores its data in that format. It was about logging the source code. It wasn't much documented, but the source code was really understandable. I wouldn't like to go into much detail how it works, but when we have the schema information from the script file, then we could interpret the binary data. There is a URL representation of the migration tool, which is interesting from here. It might be that this value of the list in main class, it's the only class which has methods outside of this migration tool, and you can call this import this URL database to make the migration process. It needs two fields. The storage, which tells us with which you can access the internal files, so the script file and the data. And this S connection is the part of the SDBC driver, which is the abstraction behind the base connections, and we need that in order to execute the commands which we read from the script file, and we can insert the data through this connection abstraction. There are two main parts of the migration tool, the schema part, which is under that, is responsible for the reading and interpreting the definition, and this URL binary code and this URL string is responsible for reading the binary file. Okay, now I would like to highlight the interesting challenges from that. The first one from Marcha, reading of the bar chart is not that interesting, but it's an example. If I looked into the binary structure, so the data file, let's say I unzipped it and I say xconf to the file so that I can see its internal structure, then I can see 4 bytes which represents the size of the bar chart and then the string. That's nothing complicated. I had some trouble also with the numerical decimal types because it was represented communicating with decimal numbers. And I tried to make my own algorithm, and that was so I was happy with that. But then I went into the internet and I found this named algorithm for that, and it works just fine. Other stuff which I had to do was the migration of datetime and so on. That's interesting because there are three different representations of that in LibreOffice. The HistoryIDB stores it as the time from 1970. SDBC stores it as a time from 0. And Firebird stores it as time from 1900. Okay, so I had to convert each format. After I finished with these tasks, I made some unit tests. I think that's not that interesting. Another problem which came up with the time, the migration of time, that it turned out that HistoryIDB stores its values as an operating system time zone dependent format. That means that if you run LibreOffice base, not the usual way, but update your date environment before you issue the command to another time zone, then you realize that that the date changed. I think most of the HistoryIDB users would surprise about that fact. Although Firebird ignores time zone questions, there is a bug report about that, and it may come in a new version, but yet it's not happening. And one possible solution would be to create a pop-up window which asks the user if